Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Heather Van Arsdell. We begin with continuing coverage of a gunfire exchange that police say allegedly happened in Thetford yesterday. News Channel 5's Jackie Bender is live in the Upper Valley Newsroom tonight with more on this. Good evening, Jackie.
Hi, Heather. Police are still investigating what exactly happened and why, and neighbors are shocked that it happened in their own town. Police say that 22-year-old Kyle Moses and 23-year-old James Moses Jr. were driving by this address in Thetford when they exchanged gunfire with the residence's owner, 62-year-old Fred Perez, and his son Thomas.
I heard something. I actually went by yesterday when I went out to mow a lawn. I see the state police and town police there.
Al Stone is a neighbor and said he didn't know the cause of the alleged incident, but police say there has been past tension between the two families, according to preliminary investigations. Neighbors are shaken up but don't think there is a threat to public safety.
Well, of course. I mean, I think it's upsetting when it happens in any town, but I think it's specific to the people and not...
Do you feel
it doesn't make me nervous.
Police say that the 2001 Volkswagen Jetta involved in the incident was hit with multiple gunshots. Around town, people say this type of violence is highly unusual in Thetford.
I've never heard of it. So I don't know what the history is on it, but I've lived here for 28 years and never heard of it, so.
Police say no one was seriously injured, but one of the men in the car had a superficial leg injury. At this time, police say no arrests have been made while the Orange County State's Attorney is reviewing the case. Heather.
Now, Jackie, if there are arrests, what charges could someone face?
Well, Heather, that's still pretty unclear right now. Police said that officials are trying to sort out whether charges will be brought, to whom, and what those charges will be. We'll keep you posted on developments. Live in the Upper Valley Newsroom, Jackie Bender, News Channel 5.